The AAU culture now is similar to when I was growing up, but it's a bit changed because, you know, it's the social media aspect now. Mm-hmm. You know, kids go out there and play for highlights instead of playing the right way sometimes. In order to be a complete player, you can't always look at the stats. There are intangibles that college coaches look at, that NBA coaches look at, that aren't always on the stat sheet. So Bismack Biyombo, right? Mm-hmm. So we were at this coaching clinic, and the coach that he was playing for previously spoke about the contract that he just got. Mm-hmm. I don't know, it was something. It was over 100 million. It was like a nice deal, right? And you know, he said he's not the most skilled guy. You know, he's not gonna light up the stat sheet, but he's the best pick and roll defender, one of the best pick and roll defenders in the league. He's, you know, and there's like little things, right? Another example, you know, you go back to Ben Wallace, and this is because it's more of my era. Yeah, I didn't play against Biyombo. Ben Wallace, Dennis Rodman. These are attitude, you know, things. They aren't, you know, I'm gonna go out and put up 30, you know, 30 and 12. It's, you know, I'm gonna shut this guy down because this is what my team needs me to do. And I'm gonna go out and get every rebound I need to get, right? And that for me is, you know, just a perfect snapshot into how you can be successful not putting up 30. It comes from the coaching staff, you know, and the parents and all that stuff. Understanding that there are successful players that don't have to, you know, go out and shoot the ball every time. And it's okay to be that guy. The impact of having a guy who isn't gonna go out and give you 20 and 10, but may give you, you know, 6 and 5, but, you know, held Durant to 20 instead of 30, you know, that 10-point spread is massive. Yeah. There's a spot on the roster for that guy everywhere. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
Everywhere.